Well, hey guys, Rylan Russell here. In today's video, I want to show you how we're running our tracks all through ProPresenter here in our worship services. Let's go. All right, so the way that we are playing our tracks during our worship services is definitely a little unorthodox. I'm going to show you first how this looks in ProPresenter, and then I'm going to break it down for you. So if we go in here to Pro, you can look here at our first song of this week is House of the Lord. And we are utilizing this function called the timeline feature. And you may not even know that that is there in ProPresenter, but we've used it for a long time. It's really handy because we can record all of our slide changes and have them just played back perfectly if ProPresenter isn't lagging. And we're not having to rely on our operators to always be on time. And so this takes away the guesswork. So for instance, when we click this first, when we click play, you're gonna see that it starts the playhead here of the timeline. And these are all cues that I've recorded previously. So the first slide fire is our background with our audience look and a timer. Here's our main screen. And if I just unplug, you'll hear the audio here. We've got click on the left and all of our tracks on the right. So it's just going out of the headphone out of our iMac here. So there goes slide one. It does an audience look to change our lower thirds to the stream. This is what the singers and band are seeing on the back screen. And here's our program that's going up to the projector. We also have a hallway feed that's all coming out of our Decklink Duo. So you can see here that it's just rolling along. Now, how do we make all of this happen? The key is that you're gonna pre-record everything that you want to happen automatically. And so the way that you do that is you just put all your slides in order, copy and paste them around. So for instance, we have this song right here that if we just click record and then you fire this background, and then now as we click through these slides, you can see that it's recording my cues. I'll click stop, I'll clear it, go back here, and you can move these around. If you wanted that to start at the very beginning, you could do that. If this was a little bit late, you can move these around. And so then you just hit play, and now it's gonna play back exactly how you recorded it. Something different about what you're seeing right here is that the audio was actually coming from this video file. You can do that and then play your lyrics over the top. I'll show you that in just a minute. But usually you would right click in that section and do add audio track. And then the other nice thing is you can click anywhere in this timeline and it will play the right part of the song. So let's just remove that so we don't get all crazy on this song. All right, let's look at another song that is kind of unique of how we're utilizing our tracks. In Raise the Hallelujah, we have this first slide, and that is actually a video. If we go into the inspector, you'll see that the playback behavior is set to stop, and the media action behavior is set to background. And that is because on our audience look, if we go into our looks here, to our lower thirds, we are not sending the media, but we are sending the slide information. And to our screen, it's the other way around. So that way, when this video is played via the timeline, it's gonna send this video to the mains, our projector, and it's only gonna send these lower thirds to the stream. And you may think, why are these lower thirds not appearing as they look on the stream? Well, it's using a separate theme in the audience look. And I will put a link to be able to get the lower thirds look that we have created for our theme here down in the description of this video. If you just submit your email, it will go straight to you. It's kind of this Red Rocks look that brings in these cinematic boxes. And it takes out paragraph breaks and makes your lyrics all just one line. And so it's really simple, but again, in the audience looks, if we go back into that cinematic lyrics with lyric video, if we look here, it is using cinematic lyrics final right there, you can see. So that's why these appear differently. And so the song after that is Waymaker. It's more of the typical style where we have this MP3 with the cues And so this just kind of takes away some of the guesswork, and you know, you can do other cool things with this where you can add a MIDI cue to a slide, or like we might drag this MIDI cue play macro onto that slide. That's the right MIDI number note to send over to our lighting computer. That's just a play command, and we've automated our lighting that way many times. Or maybe you want to have a different MIDI note for different colors, and you could create macros over here that would be your different colors and drag those onto the slides, and then it's all contained within ProPresenter. You're not having to use a separate iPad, a separate computer to do this playback stuff. Now the sticky part gets to be where, you know, I really have to put a lot of faith in my operator here. I'm not controlling anything from the stage, and so we have to work out transitions beforehand and talk about, you know, whenever I say, hey, stand with me to the congregation, that's when you know to start the track. So there's a little bit of scariness there, and it's not always perfect, but we've probably done it like this for 3 or 4, maybe more years now. And it works pretty well whenever ProPresenter, you know, doesn't fail you. So that is how we do all that. Now, one thing that you might be asking is like, well, how do you get your MP3s into here? Because, you know, everything's a multi-track. And so the easiest way that I found to do it, the quickest way to get an actual custom mix that isn't just like a download the custom mix from multi-tracks based on the 20 seconds that they give you to preview. You know, I'll buy the app track either in Prime or multi-tracks. I'll plug in my iPhone into the iMac. And then if you just search MIDI up here in your search, you'll type MIDI, and then it'll bring up this menu, and then you'll have your iPhone here that you'll click enable, and that basically means your iPhone is now an audio interface. Then what I'll do is I'll go into Audacity. Audacity is a free program for audio editing simple stuff, and I'll just go into the preferences, make sure that my recording device is the iPhone and that the playback is the built-in output, because we actually send our left and right signal out via headphone jack into our soundboard to two different direct boxes. One key of this is make sure under recording that your software playthrough of the input is checked, because now I'm just going to click record, and whenever I click play on here, it's going to play back over the sound system out through the headphones, and I can sit here and I can mix what I want to mix, you know, in the app. And so once I get that exactly how I want it through the speakers, because I want to hear what the audience is actually going to hear, the actual mix. Once I'm happy with the mix coming out of the speakers, I'm going to kill that track. I'm going to start a new track, click record. I'm going to rewind, and then I'm just going to click play and let it play all the way through. And then once it does that, I'll stop this. I'll stop the pad that automatically plays on multi-tracks. Thank you very little. And now I'm just gonna come in here and take off that front section that, you know, was there when it started of dead silence. And then another thing I like to do here is go in and split the stereo track and select all the right side. You wanna make sure your left is left, your right is right. I'll come in, do amplify, and you can choose to boost your signal as high as it can possibly go before clipping. You know, I'm just trying to normalize the audio for all of my tracks, because it seems like there's variations a lot of times. And so a lot of times if I see that I usually come down about 4 or 5 dB from wherever this says you could go. So there's some headroom there. And then you'll just look at the waveform. That looks like a healthy waveform. And so then you'll just come up here and export that as an MP3. And I like to do this at 256 kilobytes per second. And just save it. And one great thing is that anytime we do a song now, it's all contained within ProPresenter. We just drag the song from our library into our playlist. It's already got the MP3 with it. It's already got all the lyrics in sync now. All they'd have to do is click the play button on the timeline. So there's definitely downsides to doing it this way, but for us, the upsides outweigh those right now. And so if this is something you're interested in, hopefully this little walkthrough helped you out. If you have more questions, please post them in the comments, and I'll try my best to help you guys out. And like I said, this may not be the perfect way, but for us it works. So if you do want to grab that theme of the lower thirds that makes this a more cinematic Red Rocks boxed off look, I will put that in the description. And if you want to kind of see a walkthrough of how to do those, I will put a video right here of I've kind of walked that through before. And also I have some Prep Presenter templates available right here that you can go grab for free as well. Remember guys, we can do a lot of great things. Let's do it all for God's glory. We'll see you in the next one.